Lecture number 22 of Engineering Thermodynamics. In last lecture, we have seen the two types of energy, available energy and unavailable energy. Whenever heat is supplied to the system, that heat is converted into two parts, that is available part and unavailable part. Available part is a work done and unavailable part is heat rejected. Consider a Carnot cycle. TS diagram for a Carnot cycle we have already seen. Carnot cycle in ideal gas. Carnot cycle consists of two reversible isothermal process and two reversible adiabatic process. Heat addition and heat rejection in a Carnot cycle takes place in isothermal process. And work done and work consumption takes place in a reversible adiabatic process. Expansion process gives the work and compression process absorbs the work. Consider first process, isothermal heat addition process. Second, adiabatic expansion process. Third, isothermal heat rejection process. And fourth, adiabatic compression process. In expansion process, system gives the work. In compression process, system absorbs the work. Therefore, net work done is work done of expansion minus work done of compressor. During isothermal compression, during isothermal process, heat is supplied to the system, and during isothermal process, heat is rejected from the system. Therefore, net heat transfer is equal to Q1 minus Q2. We know that whenever we have to find heat supplied, we consider TS diagram, and area under the TS diagram represents the heat transfer. Therefore, this area represents the heat transfer, and the area below this line represents the heat rejected. This area represents the heat rejected. Therefore, this is a useful heat which has been converted into useful work. Consider another TS diagram in which same amount of heat, that is Q1, in which same amount of heat Q1 is supplied as a finite temperature difference. Look at here. Here, heat is supplied at temperature T1. Heat is supplied at temperature T1. Consider another process in which heat is supplied at temperature T1 dash. Same amount of heat is supplied. We know that Q is a product of temperature and change in entropy. Q is a product of temperature and change in entropy. For same amount of heat transfer, product of temperature and change in entropy must be same. Here, the heat is supplied Q1 at temperature T1 and entropy, change in entropy is delta S. For T1 dash, when the heat is supplied at T1 dash at a finite temperature difference, since T1 dash is less than T1, therefore change in entropy for this process has to be greater than delta S. And for this finite temperature difference, change in entropy is delta S dash. Both Q1 in this process and this in this process is same. Therefore, for this Q1, is equal to T1 into delta S. For this Q1, T1 dash into delta S dash. Since this Q1 and this Q1 is same, therefore T1 into delta S is equal to T1 dash into delta S dash. And this part of energy is rejected and is called as an increase in unavailable energy, or we can say decrease of available energy. Decrease in available energy. When transfer of it takes place through a finite temperature difference, there is a decrease in available energy. so transferred. Considered a reversible heat engine operating between a temperature T1 and T0. This Q1 is a heat supplied at temperature T and with a change in entropy delta S, and heat Q2 is a heat rejected at temperature T0, here heat is rejected at temperature T0, and temperature T0 is the atmospheric or the surrounding temperature. Therefore, heat rejected Q2 is the product of T0 into delta S. Therefore, work done is the available part of energy, which is equal to T1 minus T0 into delta S. This delta available part of energy is heat supplied minus heat rejected. Work done is equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected. Q1 is a heat supplied, Q2 is a heat rejected. This is a T1. Q1 minus Q2 is equal to T1 minus T0 into delta S. Assume that Q1 is a heat transfer through a finite temperature difference from a reservoir or a source at T1 to a engine absorbing heat at T1 dash lower than T1. T1 dash is a less than T1. The availability of the Q1 as received by the engine at T1 dash can be found by allowing the engine to operate reversibly in the cycle between T1 dash and T0, receiving Q1 and Q2 dash. Now, heat rejected for finite temperature difference is a Q2 dash, and Q1 is a heat supplied in both the cases in reversible Carnot cycle as well as in finite, considering finite temperature difference. Q1 is a heat supplied, but Q2 dash is a heat rejected for finite temperature difference. Now, Q1 is equal to product of T1 and delta S for first case and T1 dash into delta S dash for second case. In both the cases, heat transfer is same. Therefore, T1 into delta S is equal to T1 dash into delta S dash. But T1 is a greater than T1 dash. T1 is a greater than T1 dash. Therefore, delta S dash is a greater than delta S. Since this product is a constant, product of T1 into delta S and product of T1 dash into delta S is a constant, as the T1 is greater than T1 dash, then delta S dash has to be greater than delta S. Q2 is a heat rejected, and heat is rejected at temperature T0. T0 is a surrounding temperature. Q2 is equal to T0 delta S, and Q2 dash equal to T0 delta S dash. In second case, for finite temperature difference also, heat is rejected at temperature surrounding temperature T0. But in this case, entropy is delta S dash is greater than delta S. Therefore, delta S dash is greater than delta S. Therefore, we can say that heat rejected for finite temperature difference is greater than heat rejected for the first case. As the heat rejection increases, work done decreases, or we can say decrease in available part of energy or increase in unavailable part of energy. Therefore, work done for latter case means for finite temperature difference is heat supplied minus heat rejected, that is Q2 dash, Q1 minus Q2 dash, and Q1 is a T1 dash delta S dash, or we can say T1 into delta S, both are same, minus Q2 is equal to T0 delta S dash, and W is equal to Q1 minus Q2, and Q1 is T1 delta S minus T0 delta S dash, or we can say work done for second case, work done for finite temperature difference is less than work done for reversible process, because in reversible process we get maximum work, but for finite temperature difference we are getting less work. Therefore, W dash is less than W. Therefore, we can say that heat rejected in finite temperature difference is a greater than reversible process. The loss of available energy due to irreversibility heat transfer through a finite temperature difference between the source and the working fluid during a heat addition process is given as W minus W dash. W minus W dash is equal to Q2 dash minus Q2, which is T0 delta S dash minus delta S. T0 and delta S is a Q. Therefore, decrease in available energy is equal to T0 delta S dash minus delta S. Remember this formula, decrease in available energy, T0 delta S dash minus delta S. Thus, in the decrease in available energy is the product of lowest visible temperature and lowest visible temperature for the maximum work output is the T0. Lowest visible temperature of the heat rejection and addition entropy change in the system while receiving the heat reversibly compared to the case of reversible heat transfer from a same source. The greater is the temperature difference, that is T1 minus T1 dash, greater is the temperature difference. This T1 is the heat supplied for the reversible heat engine and T1 dash is the heat supplied for finite temperature difference. If this temperature difference is greater, the heat rejected is maximum. If temperature difference increases, Q2 dash also increases and the greater will be the unavailable part of energy supplied. That is, heat rejection will be more if T1 minus T1 dash is more. Energy is said to be degraded each time it flows through a finite temperature difference. That is why second law of thermodynamics is sometimes called as a law of degradation of energy, and energy is said to be run downhill. Look at this. This is a run downhill. Means degradation of energy is called as a run downhill. Next, availability in the non-flow process. Non-flow process means closed system. Consider a closed system in which piston cylinder arrangement is given and inside the cylinder there is a gas, and gas being a system. When the piston compresses the gas, it rejects the heat, and when piston or the gas expands, the work is obtained. Consider a heat is supplied from this piston cylinder arrangement. Heat is supplied from the gas in the cylinder to the heat engine. Heat engine takes the heat from the fluid. The part of heat taken by the fluid is converted into work done, and remaining part of heat is rejected. And this rejected part of heat is called as unavailable energy, and the converted part of heat that is worked done is called as available energy. Consider an expansion process. Process 1 to 0 is an expansion process. Process 1 to 0 is an expansion process. During this process, system gives the work done. And the heat during this process is a T1 into S1 minus H0. This expansion process takes place from pressure P1 to P0. And P0 is the atmospheric pressure. Let us consider a system consisting of a fluid in the cylinder behind the piston. Let us consider a system consist of a fluid behind the piston. The fluid expanding reversibly from initial condition of P1 and T1 to final atmospheric condition of P0 T0. Initial pressure of the gas is initial condition is 1, that is pressure P1 and temperature T1, and expands this gas up to pressure P2 and temperature T0, up to pressure P0 and temperature T0. Imagine also that system works in a conjunction with a reversible heat engine. This system is working in conjunction with a heat engine. Imagine that the system works in conjunction with a reversible heat engine which receives the heat from reversibly from the fluid in the cylinder, such that the working substance of a heat engine follows the cycle 01 L0 as shown in figure. Means this system supplies the heat to the heat engine, and this cycle is repeated again and again. Therefore, the system undergoes expansion. System undergoes 0, 1, 0, L. System undergoes 0, 1, LO. System undergoes 0, 1, LO. Where you can see that at point 1 and at point L, entropy is same. Therefore, S1 is equal to SL. And you can see at point 0 and at point L, temperature is same. Therefore, T0 and TL is equal to same. Where S1 is equal to SL, S1 is equal to SL, and T0 is equal to TL, T0 is equal to TL. The work done by the engine is given by, the work done by the engine is given by, that is, work done of engine is heat supplied minus heat rejected. Heat supplied minus heat rejected is equal to work done. And heat supplied is Q, and heat is rejected at T0 S1 minus H0. Heat rejected is T0 S1 minus H0. This is equation number 1. The heat supplied to the engine is equal to the heat rejected by the fluid in the cylinder. Whatever heat is supplied to the engine is equal to heat rejected from the cylinder. Whatever heat is supplied by the fluid is equal to the heat taken by the engine. The same heat is supplied to the engine. Therefore, for the fluid in the cylinder undergoing a process 120, we have, according to first law, heat supplied is equal to change in internal energy plus work done. But this is we are considering in the sense of system. Therefore, heat is rejected from the system. Heat is rejected from the gas, we have taken it minus. Is equal to change in internal energy plus work done by the fluid. Therefore, work done by the fluid is equal to change in internal energy, that is U1 minus U0 minus Q. Now, adding equation number 1 and 2. Equation number 1 gives the heat, work done by the engine, and equation number 2 gives work done by the fluid. Therefore, work done by the fluid plus work done by the engine is equal to U1 minus U0 minus Q. U1 minus U0 minus Q plus Q1 minus T0 minus Q1 minus T0 into S1 minus H0. Q1 minus T0 into S1 minus H0. Now Q will get cancelled. It will be like U1 minus U0 minus T0 S1 minus H0. The work done by the fluid on the piston less than the work done by the fluid, since there is no work done on the atmosphere which is at constant pressure P0. Therefore, work done on atmosphere is equal to P0 V0 minus V1. Therefore, from this work we have to subtract the work done on the atmosphere. Therefore, maximum work available is equal to U0 minus U1 minus U0 minus T0 into S1 minus H0 minus P0 V0 minus V1. Now, rearranging it as U1 minus P0 V1 U1 plus P0 V1 minus T0 S1 minus U0 plus P0 V0 minus T0 H0. We are arranging in this way. Consider this first term as a A1 and this second term as a A2. Therefore, A1 is equal to, or A is equal to U plus P0 V minus T0 S. A is equal to U plus P0 V minus T0 S. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज नॉन फ्लो अवेलेबिलिटी फंक्शन. दिस ए इज अ नॉन फ्लो अवेलेबिलिटी फंक्शन. अवेलेबिलिटी इन स्टेडी फ्लो सिस्टम फॉर ओपन सिस्टम. इन लास्ट एक्सप्रेशन वी हैव सीन इट इज फॉर नॉन फ्लो, दैट इज क्लोज सिस्टम. नाउ इट इज फॉर ओपन सिस्टम. कंसिडर फ्लूड फ्लोइंग स्टेडीली विथ अ वेलोसिटी वी, वेलोसिटी वी सी वन फ्रॉम अ रिजर्वायर इन विच द प्रेशर एंड टेम्परेचर रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट एट पी वन एंड टी वन. थ्रू एंड एपरेटस टू एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर पी जीरो. एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर इज पी जीरो एंड सिस्टम इज वर्किंग एट अ कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर एंड टेम्परेचर पी वन एंड टी वन. लेटेस्ट रिजर्वायर बी एट हाइट जेड वन. मीन्स हीट इज सप्लाइड फ्रॉम हाइट जेड वन एंड हीट इज रिजेक्टेड एट जेड जीरो. एट जेड जीरो इज एट हाइट जीरो. फॉर मैक्सिमम वर्क टू बी ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द एपरेटस द एग्जिट वेलोसिटी सी जीरो मस्ट बी जीरो. फॉर मैक्सिमम वर्क टू बी ऑब्टेन एग्जिट वेलोसिटी सी जीरो मस्ट बी जीरो. इट कैन बी शोन फ्रॉम अ प्रीवियस आर्टिकल डैट अ रिवर्सिबल हीट इंजिन वर्किंग बिटवीन अ लिमिट वुड रिजेक्ट टी जीरो एस वन माइनस एच जीरो यूनिट ऑफ हीट. वेयर टी जीरो इज एटमोस्फेरिक टेम्परेचर. दस वी हैव मैक्सिमम वर्क डन फॉर फ्लो प्रोसेस. मैक्सिमम वर्क डन फॉर फ्लो प्रोसेस हियर वी आर अप्लाइंग स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन दैट इज एच वन प्लस सी वन स्क्वेयर बाय टू प्लस जी जेड वन. दिस काइनेटिक एनर्जी एंड दिस पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एट इनलेट एंड दिस एट एग्जिट. एट एग्जिट वी आर कंसिडरिंग दैट वेलोसिटी इज मैक्सिमम, सॉरी वेलोसिटी इज मिनिमम दैट इज सी जीरो इज जीरो एंड डैटम जेड वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो. देयर फोर एच वन प्लस सी वन स्क्वेयर बाय टू प्लस जी जेड वन माइनस एच जीरो माइनस क्यू टी जीरो एच वन माइनस एच जीरो. इन सेवरल थर्मोडायनेमिक सिस्टम द काइनेटिक एंड पोटेंशियल एनर्जी टर्म्स आर निग्लिजिबल. देयर फोर वी कैन निग्लेक्ट सी वन स्क्वेयर बाय टू प्लस जी जेड वन. Therefore, W max equal to H1 minus T0 S1 minus H0 minus T0 S0. Why we are writing in this form? Because H1 minus T0 S is a B and H0 minus T0 S0 is B0. The property B is equal to H minus T0 S is called as a steady flow availability function. The equation B is equal to H minus T0S, the function B like a function A in previous derivation. B is like A is a composite property of a system and its environment. This is called as a Kanaan function. This is called as a Kanaan function. The alternate name of availability and unavailability properties, unavailability quantities, T0 delta S are the energy respectively. These are the energies, okay. The only difference between A and B is pressure. Here you can see H is equal to U plus PV. Therefore, here we are writing P and here we are writing P0. A is equal to U plus P0V minus T0S and B is equal to H minus T0S and this H is equal to U plus PV. Difference between A and B is only of pressure. Here it is atmospheric pressure and it is general pressure. Helmholtz and Gibbs function. Consider first law of thermodynamics. W is equal to Q1 minus G0 minus U1. Q is equal to product of T into delta S. U1 minus U0 and ds is equal to S1 minus S0 minus S1. We are writing it, expanding it. T is equal to S0 minus S1 minus U0 minus U1. Now we are writing in term of U1 minus TS1 minus U0 minus TS0. We are just rearranging it. Now U1 minus T0S or U minus TS represents the Helmholtz function. U minus TS is a हेल्महोल्ट्ज़ फंक्शन, दिस गिव्स मैक्सिमम पॉसिबल आउटपुट व्हेन हीट क्यू इज ट्रांसफर्ड एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर एंड इज अ केस विद अ वेरी लार्ज सोर्स. इफ वर्क अगेंस्ट एटमोस्फेयर इज इक्वल टू पी जीरो वी जीरो माइनस वी वन, देन मैक्सिमम वर्क अवेलेबल विल बी, मैक्सिमम वर्क विल बी दिस वर्क माइनस वर्क अगेंस्ट द एटमोस्फियर. W माइनस वर्क अगेन द एटमोस्फेयर इज पी जीरो वी जीरो माइनस वी वन. नाउ दिस वर्क इज इक्वल टू यू वन माइनस टी एस वन माइनस यू जीरो माइनस टी एस जीरो. नाउ रीअरेंजिंग इट लाइक यू वन प्लस पी जीरो वी वन माइनस टी एस वन माइनस यू जीरो प्लस पी जीरो वी जीरो माइनस टी एस जीरो. यू वन प्लस पी जीरो वी वन इज एच वन. U0 plus P0 V0 equal to H0. Therefore, this becomes H1 minus TS1 and this becomes H0 minus T0. Take this function as G and this function as G0 and this function is a Gibbs function. Therefore, W max equal to G1 minus G0. We can write it as G minus G0 minus G2 minus G0. Here, G0 gets cancelled and it will be G1 minus G2 and this is called as a G is equal to H minus TS is a Gibbs function. Similarly for steady flow system means for open system, maximum work is equal to G1 minus G0 plus change in kinetic energy and potential energy. But most of the cases we consider change in kinetic and potential energy as negligible, where K is the kinetic energy and P is the potential energy represents the kinetic and potential energy. It may be noted that Gibbs function J is equal to H minus TS is a property of a system where availability function A U is equal U plus P0 V minus T0S is a composite property of a system and surrounding. And again we can write we have already derived A is equal to U plus P0 V minus T0S. B is equal to U plus PV minus T0S, G is equal to U plus PV minus TS. Now difference in A and B is that only difference in the pressure. This is a minimum pressure which is atmospheric pressure and this is any general pressure. When the state 1 proceed to a dead state, when the state 1 proceed to a dead state, then this P becomes P0, this P becomes P0 and we can write A is equal to B is equal to G. Now reversibility. Now what is meant by reversibility? We have seen two types of process, reversible process and irreversible process, and all ideal processes are reversible process, and in ideal process we get maximum work done. That cannot be given by any other process. All ideal processes are reversible process and all irreversible processes are actual process, or we can say all actual processes are irreversible. Consider two engine, one engine is reversible engine and second engine is irreversible engine. Reversible engine gives the work which is a maximum work and irreversible engine giving the work which is actual work. The difference between maximum work and the actual work is called as a irreversibility. It's called as a irreversibility. The system which is not reversible is called as a irreversible. The system which is not reversible is called as a irreversible. The actual work which system does is always less than the idealized reversible work. The actual work is always less than the ideal work. Ideal work is given by reversible system and actual work is given by irreversible system. And the difference between the two is called as irreversibility of the process. If we take the difference of ideal work and the actual work, we get the value which is the irreversibility. Thus the irreversibility is written as I and it is a difference of maximum work एंड एक्चुअल वर्क. मैक्सिमम वर्क इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द रिवर्सिबल इंजिन एंड एक्चुअल वर्क इज ऑब्टेन बाय द इरिवर्सिबल इंजिन. दिस इज ऑल्सो समटाइम रिफर्ड एज अ डिग्रेडेशन और डिसिपेशन. द नॉन फ्लो प्रोसेस बिटवीन द इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट वेन द सिस्टम एक्सचेंजेस हीट ओनली विथ अ एनवायरमेंट इज अ इरिवर्सिबिलिटी. एंड इरिवर्सिबिलिटी कैन बी रिटर्न एज मैक्सिमम वर्क. एंड मैक्सिमम वर्क इज इक्वल टू यू वन माइनस यू टू माइनस टी जीरो एस वन माइनस एस टू. एंड एक्चुअल वर्क इज रिटर्न एज यू वन माइनस यू जीरो प्लस क्यू. दिस इज ऑल्सो क्यू बट दिस क्यू इज सप्लाइड एट टेम्परेचर टी जीरो. मीन्स हीट इज रिजेक्टेड, हीट नॉट सप्लाइड, हीट इज रिजेक्टेड एट एटमोस्फेरिक टेम्परेचर. एंड हियर दिस हीट इज रिजेक्टेड विद अ फाइनाइट टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस. बाय सिंप्लीफाइंग इट, इट इज टी जीरो एस टू माइनस एस वन माइनस क्यू. एंड दिस इज अ हीट रिजेक्टेड बाय द सिस्टम एंड दिस इज हीट रिजेक्टेड टू द सराउंडिंग. देयर फोर वी कैन राइट एट टी जीरो डेल्टा एस सिस्टम प्लस टी जीरो डेल्टा एस सराउंडिंग. देयर फोर आई इज इक्वल टू टी जीरो इन ब्रैकेट डेल्टा एस सिस्टम माइनस डेल्टा एस सिस्टम प्लस डेल्टा एस सराउंडिंग. एंड दिस इरिवर्सिबिलिटी फैक्टर इज ऑलवेज ग्रेटर दैन जीरो. इज इक्वल टू ऑलवेज ग्रेटर दैन एंड इक्वल टू जीरो. इट कैन नॉट बी लेस दैन जीरो, इट विल बी ऑलवेज ग्रेटर दैन और इक्वल टू जीरो. सिमिलरली फॉर स्टेडी फ्लो प्रोसेस आई इज इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू मैक्स माइनस डब्ल्यू. एंड फॉर फ्लो प्रोसेस वील कंसिडर द स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन. एंड दिस बी बी इज अ कैनन फंक्शन एंड बी इज इक्वल टू यू वन प्लस पी वी. यू वन प्लस पी वी एंड यू वन प्लस पी वी इज इक्वल टू सॉरी दिस इज इक्वल टू यू वन प्लस पी वी माइनस टी डेल्टा एस टी जीरो डेल्टा एस. मैक्सिमम वर्क इज इक्वल टू बी वन प्लस सी वन स्क्वेयर बाय टू प्लस जी जेड वन माइनस बी टू प्लस सी टू स्क्वेयर बाय टू प्लस जी जेड टू. एंड वर्क एक्चुअल वर्क इक्वल टू एच वन प्लस सी वन स्क्वेयर बाय टू प्लस जी जेड वन माइनस एच टू प्लस सी टू स्क्वेयर बाय टू प्लस जी जेड टू प्लस क्यू. नाउ हियर वी आर कंसिडरिंग क्यू एंड हियर द बी इट सेल्फ कंसिडर क्यू. क्यू इज इक्वल टू टी इन टू डेल्टा एस. एंड बी इज इक्वल टू वॉट? बी इज इक्वल टू यू वन प्लस पी वी माइनस डेल्टा एस. नाउ वेन वी सिंप्लीफाई दिस इक्वेशन सी वन स्क्वेयर बाय टू सी वन स्क्वेयर बाय टू विल गेट कैंसल सी टू स्क्वेयर बाय टू सी टू स्क्वेयर बाय टू गेट कैंसल ओनली वी विल लेफ्ट. एंड हियर एच वन विल बी कैंसल्ड ऑल्सो. वाय यू वन माइनस पी वी इज इक्वल टू एच एच वन. एंड यू टू माइनस यू टू माइनस पी वी और पी जीरो वी इज इक्वल टू एच टू. एंड एच टू विल गेट कैंसल ओनली हियर टी जीरो एच टू माइनस एस वन माइनस क्यू विल बी रिमेनिंग. एंड दिस एच टू माइनस एस वन इज अ डेल्टा एस ऑफ सराउंडिंग एंड दिस इज अ टी जीरो डेल्टा एस ऑफ सराउंड. दिस इज सिस्टम एंड दिस इज सराउंडिंग. Therefore, I is equal to T0 delta S system plus delta S surrounding. It means irreversibility is same for closed system and open system. The same expression for reversibility applies to both flow and non-flow process. The quantity T0 delta system plus delta surrounding represents an increase of unavailability energy. Now effectiveness is also called as second law efficiency. Effectiveness is defined as the ratio of actual useful work to the maximum useful work. The useful output of a system is given by increase of availability of the system. We are considering this for the heat supplied. Effectiveness is epsilon is equal to increase of availability of the surrounding लॉस ऑफ अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द सिस्टम, दिस इज वी आर कंसिडरिंग विद अ हीट रिजेक्टेड, एंड व्हेन द हीट इज रिजेक्टेड अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द सराउंडिंग इंक्रीजेस एंड अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द सिस्टम डिक्रीजेस. देयरफॉर इफेक्टिवनेस फॉर हीट रिजेक्टेड इज इंक्रीज ऑफ अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ सराउंडिंग अपॉन लॉस ऑफ अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ सिस्टम. फॉर कॉम्प्रेशन और अ हीट प्रोसेस द इफेक्टिवनेस इज गिवन बाय द इंक्रीज ऑफ अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द सिस्टम अपॉन लॉस ऑफ अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द सराउंडिंग. देयरफॉर इट कैन बी रिटन एज द रेशियो ऑफ यूजफुल वर्क टू द मैक्सिमम यूजफुल वर्क. द इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ एन एक्चुअल प्रोसेस इज ऑलवेज लेस देन यूनिटी. द इफेक्टिवनेस इज ऑलवेज लेस देन वन. Thus, the effectiveness of the process is the measure of extent to which advantage has been taken of an opportunity to obtain useful work. Now, next part is a highlight. Actually, we have completed this part, and these are the highlight. We'll see highlight in the next lecture.